Okay, the site was originally called Zama, which means dawn, because of its location, obviously, directly facing the sunrise.
This building particularly interests me. It's called Casa del Cenote, or Cenote, and then because it's built on top of a cave here, this thing, and it which contained water. And it says that it's typical of most buildings at this time in the way that it's two rectangular rooms joined together, but it says it had occupants in it. They obviously had a tomb with someone special buried in there, and they just kept walking over it. Well, its decoration consists of red coloured hand prints. Oh yeah, we see. We were reading yesterday about how the murals depict what was important to these people that lived here. There's three elements, but we can only remember corn and what was it? We're on the bus heading to Belize City.
Oh, what?
And we've just come from Chatham.
Chathamel.
And we've just been on the beach. Oh god, my mind has gone blank. Just been on the beach in Tulum for a couple of days. We're heading to Belize City now to do more of the same.
And who joins you on this trip?
Well, we've found a couple of fine young friends. There's John Boy there.
Hello. Lovely to meet you.
And Mr. C, Connor.
Hi.
It's the real girl embarrassed and giggly when there's more people around. We're usually so natural in front of the camera.
That bloke is so amusing.
He thought Maggie Thatcher was still in power.
No, really?
He said she was a gorgeous woman.
So what do you guys expect to do in Belize for the trip?
Go to
Key
Corca?
Yeah.
Go diving.
San Pedro, you go diving?
It's a lot. Saturday night in Belize City. Good night.
Yeah. Oh, tonight and tomorrow night? Oh boy. they got a very beautiful place.
Yeah.
The Lindsberg Landing. Very nice and cool.
Yeah.
Gwendolyn gave birth. Great, Evans. Was fearsome of this young child because of its beauty and its paleness and its chubby nature. And he fled forth from Picton Castle, sparing the people inside, and gave back baby to Gwendolyn to suckle. And such is the today, Picton Castle is the only standing castle that is inhabitable by generations of fine Gwendolyn folk. Beautiful thing. South Premiership, Wales, you can't beat it.
Come on then.
Oh,
isn't it
like
no, it can't be true.
It can't be true.
I bet it's there's women, seriously, just checking up.
It's a slow eviction process, that removal, low claims.
I need to go to the toilet so much. It's like when water's pouring down your back. Cascade. Water is pouring down your back. And
she's lost her shoes, that's really heavy.
That is quite heavy. Man.
Heavy shipment.
Because we're all travellers and you know how important shoes are. I've got a piss. No, I'll talk.
Okay, that means you have to do a minute and a half when you come back.
Okay, well, you come up with a scum.
Vic, tell us.
Right, I came back from the bathroom. The shoes were quite clearly outside the door. Okay, I thought. You know, can't be too trusting. We're travelling.
Like
every possession counts. You need it.
Like
you need it.
Like
you
gotta
have it.
Vicky kicked them in. I put them outside. She went, someone stole them. I said, no, they really stink. They'll be all right here. And they've gone. They're not there. And I asked that woman.
They didn't stink enough.
No, they didn't, obviously. And then that woman said, oh, I don't know. And she asked me what rank they were. And she said she'd keep an eye out if anybody started selling a pair of shoes. I was like, oh, great. Bastards. I hope they get a foot rot.
Can I just try something? Can we all pretend to be from this life and I'll try and do it on camera?
Oh no, what? Flicking between all of us.
Millie, I've got...
Egg! Will you fix me a fucking drink?
No, I've got...
Egg!
Yeah.
Could you just chill out?
having a hot bath, okay?
Just because I've got an alcohol addiction. Eggs, the joke is on you. Lighten up, wake up.
Wake up, just back off.
Come on.
Anna.
I'm not meaning.
I mean, you really can go too far sometimes.
Just back off, sit down, and chill out, and
well,
just worry about your lesbian thing.
If you won't shag me, then I can't chill out, can I, Miles?
I'm marrying
Phoebe.
You don't even know her fucking name.
Yeah, but I love her, and she's much more my sort.
I just had a fucking Budweiser.
Fucking, I mean, fuck off.
You're
fuck
in the
off.
Cinema.
We are watching this on screen.
Don't fucking step out of character, you cunt.
Oh, Phoebe's getting left out. Good acting, well done.
Woman every man, join the band of love. Stand up, stand up, stand up.
Does anybody really want tea?
You better get ready.
Bruno, fuck up! Five star! No, we can't listen to five star.
Five star.
This is the last song from, and then it goes into something else.
Oh, that's a tragedy. I've got a few tips like this, and you know what it's got on it? You know that H2O song?
H2O?
Do you remember H2O?
No.
Is that an oxygen book?
Oxygen.
By Jean-Marc Jarre or
no. H2O, the band, is like, I don't remember now. Sorry.
Okay.
Never mind. That's cool. Get on this fun.
When he puts that ring on my finger tonight,
that proves
you lot will see.
Good day! Welcome to you!
Now, what's your name?
Called Indian.
Indian.
My name is Lloyd, but where I come from is California.
No, well. Do you like it here?
I don't like it, I love it here. Another sycamore tree. A girl want me bow, but me tell her to flee. It was another sycamore tree. Sun stopped shining for me.
Do you know Mark, the guy that works the bar at the INI?
Yeah, Mark.
He's from his weird Honduras accent. Yeah. It's really hard to follow.
If I would start speaking Creole, it'd be hard for you to understand me because that way when I speak, I usually speak it first. When I start to talk Creole, you know, and I stand on the bomb up ladder or something. So. Hello, my name is Greg and I'm showing you girls around the island.
No, no, no.
Hi, well today we're in Key Corker. Beautiful island. You find the locals very helpful and friendly. You can get you whatever you like, they'll cook you dinner as well.
That's good.
I haven't really had a lot of time to do drawings, though.
What do you use? Is it charcoal?
Yeah, it's just charcoal. King Selassie, when he taught us about human rights and equality, you know?
Hmm.
You're going to burn this one, right? You have a light?
I have a light, no.
All the time,
oh. Your face.
Many a sorrow, many a joy.
I'm really bad. I get
that. I told you. I said.
Well, I went back by the hideaway because I never want to be to the next
island. What are your impressions of Belize so far? Remember when you first arrived?
I thought it was wicked. I know that sounds really crap, but like when we're driving around that taxi and it's playing under the sycamore tree, and everyone's been nothing but nice to us.
It's very like how you think the Caribbean would be.
It's a bit worrying though, because some of the men, I think they think that we're all going to shag them.
Everyone seems very friendly, and I think you have to be a bit careful, don't you? No, but you know, because like those girls got ripped off, you know.
Okay, check.
Just stick it on.
Wow, big speakers.
Yeah, we got different music.
Yeah.
You had a little yellow tape player last night, and you had your hair all up.
That wasn't you. Was it him?
He had those trousers on. He was giving it to somebody. We go around to people's houses and you just sit on the floor, man, and it's like the equilibrium, like, just transcends around.
Look how hard they have to work him, and it's
like,
I think this is like a good insight into Belizean life.
No, Greg, don't go in your trousers, you're losing your trousers. Do you want to do my hair?
Yeah, I'm down at Tom's Hotel. You can come by the bus.
Thank you.
You're right.
Okay.
Today is
Wednesday.
It's Wednesday or Tuesday.
Thank God it's Friday and we're in Belize.
It's not Friday.
We're in Belize and we're in this place called San Ignacio. And the weather is hot. And the Spice Girls are playing on the sound system. Zach's got a giant erection going on. It's kind of keeping us girls kind of thrilled here. So you want to know something about Belize?
Yeah.
Right. For the Belizeans, for a start.
You can find out about it in this little book here. That's what that Eddie guy said to me. He said, where are you going next? I said, down to Honduras. And he went, you just follow, don't you? You just follow. I said, yeah, you got it right. And it says here that the Zunashananchunich ruling family were here. It's the primary ritual focus. Maybe we'll have a look up there, shall we, Melissa?
Uh-huh.